This is the Iowa Weather Report for Thursday, December 5th, 2013. Now our first look at the 0Z GFS model run. This is at noon today. We have the trough still over the west with the energy moving through the Great Lakes, also across the desert southwest. Then the cold air is going to be just flooding into the state today. Highs will be struggling to be in the teens, maybe single digits far northwest with where there was some snow. Otherwise, teens to lower 20s and maybe mid-20s in the south and east with partly to mostly cloudy skies. It'll still be a few more clouds in the southeastern counties, otherwise mainly sunny on Friday. But highs will be struggling again, high single digits north, maybe not even reaching zero in some places. Saturday morning will be quite cold, sub-zero readings for most of the state except the far south and southeast. High Saturday, likely in the single digits north to maybe near 20 southeast. And then the next snowstorm comes in here on Sunday. Better chances of seeing some heavier snow totals look to be south of an Omaha to Waterloo to Prairie du Chien line at this point. This will be quick in and out because by Monday it's long gone. And it turns sharply colder again, as if it could get any colder. Lows back down below zero, highs struggling into the single digits and teens once again. And this also looks to be the case on Tuesday. Could be a few more clouds with a clipper system moving across Minnesota and Wisconsin with a little bit of snow activity there. But still cold around here, still single digits and teens for highs, maybe near 20. And that looks to be the case here on Wednesday as well, with maybe a little bit of snow activity with a system that'll quickly come through during the morning hours into the midday and then be east of the state into the afternoon. And then even here a week from today, pretty much a zonal flow, but it's coming out of the west-northwest. Trough axis off the or over New England and into the east coast. But it's still relatively cold and storm systems moving relatively fast. And the next one is already on top of us with maybe some snow across the western and northern counties of the state by a week from today. And that system could bring a lot of changes later into the week. A couple days later, as we go into the extended period on December the 16th, we still have this quick moving flow, very quick moving flow, around the polar vortex, which is located just north of Hudson Bay. And that means we'll have quick shots of some snow, maybe a little bit of wintry mix, if temperatures can get close to freezing, but that could bring us a couple inches of snow if this is to be right, but it's another quick in and out. And then at the end of the forecast on December the 20th, a couple days before Christmas, we still have a fairly quick flow, but it's now turned more out of the west-southwest. Peace Energy just to the west of San Francisco, another north of New England. And it looks like we may have a little bit more snow. This looks to be maybe light snow showers or flurries, some rain moving into California, a cold front moving off the east coast, and a fairly big windstorm moving out of the Canadian Maritimes. Satellite image from last evening, we have the storm system moving across the middle part of the country down into the south. It is bringing rain, snow, going to bring a lot of wintry precipitation and a big mess across Texas, Oklahoma, and east and northeastward. You can see that on the watch warning map from last evening. Winter storm warnings in Minnesota and North Dakota and northern Wisconsin, but across New Mexico, Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Missouri, and north and eastward, it's going to be a real mess. QPF chart, precipitation over the next 5 days through Monday evening at 6 o'clock, showing amounts around here, maybe about a quarter of an inch, maybe to a third of an inch. Heaviest precipitation will be from Oklahoma and Arkansas northeastward into the Mid-Atlantic and New England.